Hi, I'm Peter. Welcome to Back to Basics. There's nothing worse than not being able to deliver results to your customer due to an outage. I remember when I was unable to send reports to New York City Hall right before a press conference. So how do you protect your teams and your business against this without breaking the bank? Using AWS for disaster recovery, or DR, is a common hybrid pattern when you use AWS as your backup site. This pattern has you continuously replicating your on-prem applications and databases into AWS to have business continuity. This creates a DR strategy with low recovery time and recovery point objectives. This means you can quickly recover from a failure and minimize data loss. If we had used this strategy, it would have saved me from having to manually create those reports, which we all know can be error-prone and very stressful. So let's see how we can do this using AWS Elastic Disaster Recovery, or DRS. With DRS, you choose an AWS region as your disaster recovery target. DRS will continuously replicate your on-prem application servers, including databases, into a staging area within an Amazon VPC using block-level replication. This staging area only retains a copy of your data. Nothing is turned on, which means you're not paying for anything other than storage. When you experience a failure, DRS uses the staged resources to automatically create a full capacity environment in a target VPC. You can launch recovery instances on AWS in minutes, using a desired point in time. When your primary site is up and running again, you can use DRS to fail back to your primary site and stop paying for the resources in AWS. We're not breaking the bank here because we're only paying for the resources when we need them, instead of committing to a long-term contract for another site. Even with a solid DR strategy, you should make sure you have the right business reasons. One anti-pattern I see with customers is not quantifying the business impact of a disaster. You can use something like a risk analysis to help you measure not only the financial cost of a disaster, but in my case, the loss of public trust toward New York City government because of lack of transparency. A risk analysis like you see here will help formulate the right DR strategy for your business. Regardless of what DR strategy you use, remember to test your DR plans. Running drills can help minimize the number of unknowns during a failure. When conducting disaster recovery drills, test things like isolating your recovery subnets to prevent potential conflicts with the source location. You can do this using route table rules, network access control lists, or restrictive security groups. If you use DRS, you can run disaster recovery drills with the service. You can test and see how your applications run natively on AWS. Drills are non-disruptive and do not impact your source servers. Plus, they're free. But what about backups? Isn't backing up data enough? Backing up data can protect you to some extent, but what happens when your data is corrupted? There's a difference between backup and disaster recovery. While backup is primarily a means to protect your data, DR refers to the plans and processes for quickly reestablishing access to applications, data, and IT resources after an outage. Both backup and DR maintain copies of historical data, but simply having copies of data doesn't mean that will help keep your business running. DR ensures business continuity by providing a robust, tested solution that enables normal business operation until the disaster is resolved. In this episode, we talked about patterns to ensure business continuity of your on-prem applications by using AWS as your disaster recovery site. Check out the links below to learn more about disaster recovery strategies on AWS. Thanks for watching Back to Basics, and see you next time.